Now, the House of Representatives set out to host a 100% in-person State of the Nation address next month, the first time since the start of the pandemic. It will also be President-elect Marcos's first SONA. But House Secretary General Mark Landro Mendoza said they are also prepared to host another hybrid SONA, depending on the COVID situation as well as the wishes of the next president. Lawmakers will get an upgraded Batasang Pambansa when they start their terms on June 30th. Mendoza said they are now finishing ongoing repairs and renovation, including the expansion of the capacity of the plenary hall. The House also overhauled its security system and fixed the offices of the Secretariat. U.S. Second Gentleman Douglas Emhoff set to lead President Joe Biden's delegation for the inauguration of Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Thursday. The husband of U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris will be joined by Virginia Representative Bobby Scott, who is the first American of Filipino descent in the U.S. Congress. U.S. Budget Deputy Director Nanny Coloretti, the highest-ranking Filipino-American in Biden's administration, will also be part of the delegation. The White House did not mention why Biden could not attend the event. Marcos personally invited Biden to attend his inauguration, but he is currently in the Bavarian Alps for the G7 summit. Rehearsals for the inauguration of President-elect Marcos in full swing, with just days to go before the ceremony. A dry run of the civic and military parade has been conducted in the vicinity of the National Museum in Manila, where Marcos will take his oath. Members of the Philippine Air Force, the Philippine Navy, the Philippine Coast Guard, and the Philippine Army participated in the dry run. The Philippine National Police also held a rehearsal of its security protocols near the Philippine International Convention Center in Pasay. A gun ban in Metro Manila takes effect today until July 2nd. Re-elected Senator Risa Ontiveros officially becomes the next leader of the opposition. Ontiveros took her oath before outgoing Vice President Lenny Robredo on Monday. She was accompanied by her three daughters. Ontiveros said she would continue her advocacies at the Senate, including efforts on COVID-19 response and other health initiatives. She also vowed to continue the fight against false information. Robredo, meanwhile, said she would stand by the lawmaker and would extend help whenever she needs it. Over in Ilocos Norte, preparations are also ongoing for the oath-taking of several local officials, including the son of the president-elect this afternoon. Let's get an update now from our correspondent, Wena Cos. Wena, go ahead.
Yes, Denise, the Loag City Centennial Arena is ready for the inauguration later this afternoon of Ilocos Norte officials. Mayors and vice mayors of the 21 towns and two cities of Ilocos North will take their oaths of service in front of re-elected Governor Matthew Marcos Manotok. Officials and guests are expected to arrive in an hour, while the oath-taking should begin a few minutes past 4 o'clock. Among those who will be sworn in is President-elect Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.'s son, Sandro Marcos, who won his first political bid as Ilocos North's first district representative. From the initial information given to us, he will be sworn in by Barangay Captain Edwin Vea of Barangay Pasnal 1 from the town of Bacara. Governor Matthew Marcos Manotok will take his oath for his second term in front of his mother, Senator Aimee Marcos. His aunt, Vice Governor-elect Cecilia Araneta Marcos, will also be sworn in later. Several trucks and vehicles carrying local policemen, personnel, and ambulances from the local disaster risk reduction management, as well as the Ilocos Norte Bureau of Fire Protection, have arrived here at the Centennial Arena since 1 p.m. to secure the venue. But there has been no confirmation so far whether or not President-elect Marcos Jr. will attend his son's inauguration as congressman. We will be standing by here to give you the latest updates from Lawag City, Ilocos Norte. Denise?
Thanks for that update, Wena.